Ready.
She sells seashells down by the seashore.
Now, let's do it fast.
Is that even how you say it?
She sells seashells down by the seashore.
Okay, fine. She sells seashells.
Ready?
And here we go. Welcome, you guys. We are so excited about today's episode because we get to show you one of our brand new molds. You guys are gonna love it. I don't know. It's amazing. I do know, actually. It's beautiful. Check out all the deets. As usual, it is... Yes, it has incredible amounts of detail. Mm-hmm. It has the micro rim, patented micro rim, to give you that nice clean edge. And today you get to see it in action because we are going to make a set of three wall pieces with this mold. So let's get started. The first thing we're going to do is we're going to dust a little bit of cornstarch into our mold cavity that we're going to be using.
Question. Is that necessary?
Thank you for that question, Josie.
I'm the color commentator this time.
I know, and she's, I can tell. I can tell it's gonna be awesome.
I'm gonna show you how it feels.
It is not necessary. I actually do it without using the cornstarch.
I do with.
Many people do with, and many people do without. So just try it out and see which one you like.
The reason why I like doing with is because the less tension you put on your casting when you're removing it, the more detail it retains and you don't get disfiguring or warping if it comes out easily, if it just falls out.
It is actually true, and I would probably use it if I thought to use it before I got started, but I always forget.
Yeah.
It works out okay, but it would come out much easier if I did cornstarch. So you just dust a little bit in there and then you dump out any excess because you don't want a bunch of cornstarch in there. This is our air dry clay. It's literally the best clay on the market. I kid you not. So, literally. And our stockists have this as well as the molds. So link in the description to the store locator and list of online stores.
What do you do with this?
Yes, thank you. Such a good color commentator you are. You put it inside.
Our viewers would like to know how you keep it in between using. Always sealed up.
And then I just grab a chunk about what I think I'm gonna need. I like to get a little bit more rather than a little bit less. So it's better to have a little excess. And I just kind of roll it to the basic shape and then I start putting it into the cavity.
Really?
Now, with the cornstarch, if it tends to pop up, just kind of steady it with your hand and really press it in really good. There we go.
Sorry, I can't keep my hands off it.
I know. She's not a very good sidekick.
I'm not a sidekick.
She's not used to it. She's not used to being the little sister. And then you just use your thumb, or you can use, Josie, do you want to show them the using the spatula? I typically use my thumb, but using the spatula is awesome as well.
So, like, what I do is, like you said, mostly use my thumb and just really get it in there from center out, getting the excess. But then you can take this to really use it at a low angle. You don't want a high angle, it'll pull it out. You want a low angle. And part of the beauty of the micro rim is that it's creating two high spots that reduces surface tension. Surface tension is what's gonna cause that casting to pull out of the cavity. So because of that nice micro rim, you can really get a nice clean edge without pulling it back out of your cavity.
And do any other molds have the micro rim, Josie?
What do you mean? You mean other brands?
Yeah.
Not that I'm aware of.
They don't. Whoa. Oh, I thought this one was empty. Look at how, careful.
Oh, yeah.
You weren't
the
careful.
Tail.
The tail. It's delicate. See, if I was doing this by myself,
I can't let you. There we go.
Oh, we did it. It's so. Yes. The little delicate pieces. You just want to be extra careful.
I can't.
And look at it. It's pretty.
Look what was just pretty. Look what was just born.
Little baby seahorse.
Little baby seahorse.
I love it. Okay.
So cute. I'm going to kind of curl that. Okay.
It's time to let the baby seahorse go now, Josie.
I can't. Look at that.
Ooh, that is going to be so beautiful. All right, we're moving on. Get the glue.
All right.
And glue this beautiful specimen down.
Okay, so you start gluing. Mm-hmm. Well, you talk about that, but I also want to notice this. Mm-hmm. That these are mirror image. So what that means is you can take this and you can use them facing each other in a symmetrical layout, or even if your layout's not symmetrical, you can have a seahorse in your layout facing inwards, or your composition, and then the other one on the opposite side facing inwards, or what have you. Or, and this is very, very cool.
It is super cool. This is my favorite part. Go ahead.
You can make two of these facing and then glue them back to back.
So you have a double-sided three-dimensional seahorse.
Yes. So think about that for like
Christmas ornaments. Yes.
Or any kind of hanging like bobblies.
Like a coastal Christmas tree.
Oh, coastal Christmas. Yes. How adorable.
Okay. Okay. I'm going to glue this down. When you are using glue, we like to use the type-on quick and thick.
Yeah.
It is great if you're working on a vertical surface because it won't slide and it dries very quickly.
It's quick. And it's thick.
Exactly.
That was super corny.
So I use plenty. You want to use plenty of the glue. Is that too much?
Yeah.
I get a little sloppy with it. I end up with a lot of cleanup. But
it's okay.
Do we have a little spatula? Use your finger.
Use your finger and just get. You want it definitely well supported. Probably not quite that much, but I'm totally taking one for the team here.
Okay, there we go. And he's ready to place down.
Oh, yes. This is so, these are our new cradled reversible wood blanks using here.
Yes.
Right?
Our wood blanks, which we'll show you in a second. Are reversible. We are using the side that allows it to be a shadow box.
Yes. With a built-in frame.
Which works really nicely with the molds.
You are so right when you said I'm not a good sidekick.
No.
I'm not.
That's all right. I'm used to it.
You want to make sure it's fully seated, embedded, but you do not want to squish any of the detail down. So.
Right, exactly. And as it's drying, you will want to come back to it every, 20 minutes or so and press it down because it's going to want to lift. Air dry clay has, it tends to shrink as it dries. So you'll have a little bit of warping, maybe some cracking. That is normal. It's the character of the clay.
Yeah.
You want to work with that because it's part of what makes it special and unique.
Definitely. I'm just using this brush to gently remove any of the excess squirted out lumps of it. But in general, it's more the shrinkage and slight bits of cracking that you'll get here and there.
Mm-hmm.
Because when you've got it glued down, you don't get a lot of warping. But you do get a lot of, or not a lot, you get some cracking.
I just mean the air dry clay in general as it dries, you'll get warping. But if you glue it down, that is actually one of the reasons you want to glue it down while it's wet.
Exactly.
Before it's dry.
That's fabulous.
Excellent, I love it. So, now we are going to...
There's two different ways
you
could go, right, from here?
Why don't you explain, because I have no idea what you're talking
about. You can keep going outlaw and paint it while it's wet before it's dried.
You can paint it now.
Or you can let it dry and then paint it. If you have the time and you aren't as antsy like we sometimes are, letting it dry allows you a little more, you can be a little rougher when you're painting without worrying about softening your detail.
You can also, as it shrinks, it sometimes will leave a border unpainted. Mm-hmm. And so you can go in as you go in and paint it.
Exactly.
Yeah. So we actually have some, what we call step outs, and it allows us to keep moving. And we use a different mold for each one. And so now I grabbed the wrong one. This one is all ready to go, so we can show you the next step, and it is dry. So we've allowed this one to dry, but again, you can paint it wet. So, you wanna slap that on there and we'll get it painted?
Right in here.
Perfect, perfect.
Oh, that's way more than we needed, but that's
all
right.
No, I don't think so.
No? Okay.
I mean, I do tend to use too much of everything, but.
This one. This is nice and soft.
And
since this is all the way dry,
you can get rough with it, like she said.
Exactly.
I find that to be a big advantage, actually.
It is. And you're not going to be softening any of those details if you have it all dry. But it really does work both ways. It's just you do approach it a little bit differently.
True, true.
If you are... So I'll go ahead and paint the whole, maybe a little more.
See, I told you it wasn't too much. That might be too much.
True, true.
I love these new wood blanks because you can really create a frame. So we're gonna use all white, but you can use a different color around the rim and it really gives it that natural framed look.
It does.
And they're really high quality. The joints are really tight and it's just really, really durable. Very, very sanded smooth. They're a really high quality wood blank.
And in a great selection of size ranges, we have 6 sizes for being able to create amazing mixes and gallery walls.
Yes.
So you guys, you're gonna love it. You're gonna get so creative and be creating like just walls of art.
We made it easy for those of you who don't like to go to Home Depot and have the boards all cut, which is more like me. I like it ready made, buy it off the shelf and go to town.
Sweet, so we have one that has been
already painted.
Mm-hmm. So let's go
ahead and grab that one. And we used an even different one for this one because when we were all done, we wanted to have a set of 3 ready to go. So we've got this one all painted. And in order to pop the detail, we are going to use a little bit of glaze and we're going to use a beautiful blue to really give it that oceany feel.
Yes.
Okay. Do you want to grab I'll let you do the glaze.
Okay. Let me get wet. I like to have a nice, wet paper towel on hand whenever I'm doing like a glaze. Let me grab this.
Sarah's getting you one.
Oh, awesome. And a brush.
Ooh, that is a pretty color. I like it. It's almost like a periwinkle.
Yes, isn't it pretty? Mm-hmm. So I'm going to get this nice, I'm going to basically get it all the way wet and then squeeze it mostly out. Mm-hmm. So, it's plenty damp.
Make sure they hear you.
Oh, yes, that's important. Okay, and now I am going to be very liberal, and then I'm going to liberally wash it off. So, kind of dapple it off. And this is going to pop your detail. It's so pretty!
It is. You could use 3 different shades of blue if you wanted to. Or you can actually also, like in my home, I would go with neutrals probably, and I would use like a sand color to pop the detail.
Yes.
Oh, that's really pretty.
Isn't it pretty?
Mm-hmm.
Now this was about 1 part paint to 5 part waters, a very, very diluted. Mm-hmm. You can adjust that depending on the effect you want.
That's right.
we wanted a really light and airy.
Obviously, now, the more water you use, the more translucent and pale the wash is going to be.
Exactly. Now I'm just really kind of popping the highlights, pulling some of more of it out. There we go. Now, if you opted to not allow it to dry before you painted it, you're going to be much gentler. You're going to brush it on and just be very, very gentle, because you're going to reactivate that paint. And so that step looks quite different if you haven't allowed it to dry.
Just to clarify, you have to allow the white paint to dry before you put the wash on.
Yes, to crust.
To crust, right.
Exactly. Exactly.
But this has dried for a while overnight, yes. So we're able to be a little bit heavier handed.
Yes, exactly.
That's
so
really pretty.
Isn't it pretty?
Yes.
I feel like after this dries, going back in and sanding the face of this quite a bit and letting the wood tones come through, I feel like would be a pretty
and
contrast.
Then painting gold. Around the edge.
Gold looks so pretty.
We won't do that on camera. We'll do that off camera, but you'll see it in the final pictures. Okay, you guys, that is this project. We're really excited you joined us, and we're super excited about this mold. We know you're gonna love it. Have an awesome time. Don't forget to hit subscribe below, and there's links in the description so that you can go get more tutorials.
Yes.
Bye, guys.
Seashells down by the seashore.
By the seashore. Mm-hmm. That was good.
Good enough.
Okay. That's going to have
to do. All right.